So we are here back with Cellguru. Very important discussion right now. 3G, the relevance, and especially what can you expect from 3G? It's about to get started. You could have a 3G phone and service with you in a matter of days. But what can you expect? What will it cost? What can you do with it? Let's find out. Two gentlemen with me, Mr. Bhargav from MTNL and Mr. Wahi from Aksh. Let's find out. I'll start with you. So first of all, very excited. Congratulations. First company to be out with 3G. We've already seen what you're doing with it. It's all looking great. But let's get down into the real brass tacks of it. So what can we expect? What's the USP? It's not just going to be about voice quality being better, only just video or only just data. But from within all of this, what's the biggest USP that the customer can expect?
The customer can expect higher speeds, higher bandwidth, and better customer experience while downloading. So the biggest application that I look for is anywhere, anytime internet access, which is going to become a reality once you have 3G connection with you.
Okay, so we're talking HSDPA right here, right? We're not talking anything lesser than HSDPA in terms of the overall technology behind the infrastructure, right?
Yes, we have HSDPA ready network. So we are talking of HSDPA speeds as well, yes.
Okay, now, but that's the theory part of it, right? So now the most important question, and I know that the minute this show is going to get over, we'll be flooded with emails and the questions. So let's ask that question right now so we can save our inbox right now. What speeds can we expect? In reality, we know theoretically 3 Mbps, 4 Mbps, all of that is possible. You can go into incredible numbers. But what can we really expect? A everyday user using it on, let's say, unlimited download and bandwidth, what will we be able to give?
Our normal broad fixed line broad customers, they are used to 256 to 2 Mbps.
Right.
Our wireless customers also can expect up to 2 Mbps speeds with HSDP.
Okay. Now, having got all of that, let's come to the people who will actually make the experience more rich and more enjoyable, the content. So, first of all, just with the infrastructure and everything else, are you satisfied with the kind of resolution, picture quality, audio quality that you've been able to do?
We have tested it on an iPhone, we have tested it on an Omnia, we have tested it on an N96.
So all the big screen phones that really make the whole experience more enriched.
Correct.
Okay.
On those phones, obviously, it is as good as a normal TV experience that you would have in terms of both the rate at which the frames change, the sort of resolution that you get, and so on and so forth.
Okay.
We have also tested it on the 2.75 or even 2.5 phones. You do get a feed and you can sort of have a look at it, but you obviously don't enjoy it.
So what can we expect? Are we talking about 100 channels? Are we talking IPTV completely translated from the ones that we have on television, translated to a mobile phone, or are there going to be subtle differences?
We have 32 channels provided for. Mm-hmm. As the demand grows, we'll increase it. Things like normal news, things like sports. And
things
I think
like catching up on Cellguru.
Yeah,
I'm sure these are things that we.
Sure.
I'm sure they'll be catching up.
Sure. Besides the live channels, where, well, interestingly, in the proof of concept, the tickers were very clear, absolutely clear.
Really, so because I was about to ask that, are you going to be customizing parts of it? Because obviously, whatever's happening on a normal television, a 42-inch plasma versus a 3-inch screen,
and you had perfect clarity in the tickers for the stock prices, for example, on CNBC or NDTV Profit. So that's what I'm trying to highlight. That see, because that is where the real test of the quality of experience comes in. Mm-hmm. The other thing I wanted to
on a cricket match, if you can spot the ball.
So within the IPTV parts, will all the features translate? Will I be able to go back 3 or 4 days? Will I be able to stream what I want? Is it choice on demand, everything that you have on IPTV?
See,
or are you saying certain things may not translate?
At the moment, I'm talking from a technology perspective.
Yeah.
From a technology perspective, all features available on the IPTV will be available to you on the mobile TV.
Okay.
It is then ultimately a commercial decision, because obviously there will be a price to pay for whatever.
Isn't 3G going to be more for the urban city dweller who wants entertainment, and that's where the money will be made from, and everything else? This is a huge debate that is always on. Personally, what do you think? I know from your business perspective, obviously, at the moment, your audience is all city, more or less. But eventually?
3G will open up new vistas. It's not only in the area of entertainment, but in the business applications, there could be n number of applications. For example, remote monitoring,
telemedicine,
telemedicine, e-governance, education. It's once the connectivity is there, I'm sure there would be innovative applications that can be put on.
Last question, one sentence answer from each of you. You personally, what is the one thing about 3G that you're going to be using the most? One sentence.
HSDPA card.
Which I'm sure you're already testing
yes,
right now, right?
I already do. And it's,
okay, what is the one perfectly. Thing that you're totally excited about and you're going to be using it the day they commercially launch it?
Stock trading.
Really? Okay, so that's going to be the big USP.
See, because I think it still happens on SMS and stuff like that. It doesn't give you that same thrill.
Exactly.
When you actually see the stock, the graph, and then you say, okay, this is the time to buy. The excitement
so,
that will
so
give you.
So you want the entire picture
exactly.
to happen right in front
exactly.
of you. Excellent, gentlemen. I think it's great that we have 3G. I don't know how many years we've been constantly saying, aayega, aayega, aayega. It's here. Congratulations. Fantastic to know what 3G is going to look like. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
So 3G becomes a reality, not a day too soon, or may I just say, maybe 2 years too late. But it's happening in your town. You're going to have a 3G connection very soon. One more thing, on that 3G, maybe this is a value-added service that could really give you some benefit.
Here is a really useful search engine by BPL Mobile to help mobile subscribers hunt for anything and everything in a city. Mumbai Search at Cafe, fashion exclusively for Mumbai, can help locate every little thing you're looking for in this vast city. Or maybe you're looking for a Ford Fiesta dealer at Kandivali, Mumbai Search at Cafe is where you look up at. Simply call *111*1# to begin Mumbai Search. You will get an activation message. Key in 1 for Mumbai Search or simply enter keywords to what you're looking for in the search tab with the prefix 1. For Ford Fiesta at Kandivali, type the search topic. An instant SMS in return will give you just what you're looking for with all the details to complete your search quick and easy.